So our next topic is sequence, impedance of transmission line. Okay. Suppose we have a transmission line and XS is the self inductance of the line. Okay. So this is phase A, this is phase B, and this is phase C. So in all the three phases, XS is the self inductance of the line, and the inductance between phase A and phase B is XM, phase A and phase C is XM, phase B and phase C is XM. This is the mutual inductance between two phases, and we have a return path here. We have a return path. The voltage across these two is VA. Voltage across these two is VB, and voltage across these two is VC. Similarly, voltage across this and return path is VA dash. This is VB dash, and this is VC dash. Now, here XS is the self inductance, and XM is the mutual inductance. Okay, between any line. Okay, so what is delta VA? That is VA minus VA dash. Suppose the current in A is IA, current in B is IB, and current in C is IC. So what is delta VA? Delta VA will be IA into JXS plus, how A and B is connected mutually, right? So this will be IB into JXM, and how phase A and phase C is connected, here phase A and phase C is connected mutually, right? So we will write IC into JXM. Similarly, what will be delta VB? Delta VB will be VB minus VB dash, and this is IA into JXM plus IB into JXS self inductance plus IC into JXM mutual inductance. Now what will be delta VC? Delta VC will be VC minus VC dash. So what will be VC minus VC dash here? VC minus VC dash will be IA into JXM plus IB into JXM plus IC into JXS. Okay. Now, if we write this equation in form of matrix, it will be delta VA, delta VB, this will be delta VC, is equal to J j I take it as common, this will be xs xm xm, this is xm xs xm, and this will be xm xm xs. Okay, I wrote the same equation in matrix form. This will be IA, this will be IB, and this will be IC. Okay, so these are the phase value. Okay, this is the phase voltage and this is the phase current. Okay, so what if I change this phase value into the symmetrical component, that is VP is the phase voltage. How we convert into symmetrical component with the A operator, right? So VP is equal to A into symmetrical component of the voltage. Similarly, phase current will be equal to A into symmetrical component of the current, right? So what will be here? This is nothing but VP minus VP dash, right, is equal to, this is Z into, this is IP, phase current. Now if I convert this into symmetrical component, this will be A into VP minus VP dash, sorry, VS symmetrical component, this will be symmetrical component, VS minus VS dash is equal to Z into A into symmetrical component of the current. Okay, and what we can write, delta VS, that is A inverse into Z into A into IS, symmetrical component of the current. Now see, A inverse A will give you diagonal component, okay, and it's better to convert this into diagonal component. So if you do this, A inverse ZA, A inverse Z into A, this will be, what is A inverse? That is 1 by 3, 1, 1, 1, 1 alpha, or sorry, A square and 1 A square A. What is Z? That is XM, sorry, XS, XM, XM, this will be XM, XS, XM, this will be XM, XM, XS. Okay. And what will be the A? That is 1, 1, 1, 1 A square A, 1 A square, right? So if you solve this, you will get XS minus XM, XS minus XM, and this you will get XS plus 2XM. Okay, so I will put this value in this position. What we will get? This will be the symmetrical component, right? So D V A positive sequence component, D V A negative sequence component, and D V A zero sequence component will be equal to XS minus XM. This will be XS minus XM, and this will be XS plus 2XM. Okay, and here you will get symmetrical component of the current, that is IA1 positive sequence current, IA2 negative sequence current, and this will be zero sequence current. Okay, so in this equation what is Z1 positive sequence impedance, that is XS minus XM, right? And what is Z2? This is the positive sequence component, this is the negative sequence component, right? See, see here, this is the positive sequence component, right? This is the negative sequence component, and this is the zero sequence component, right? So what is the positive sequence component? Xs minus xm. Negative sequence component, that is xs minus xm. So we can tell positive sequence component is equal to negative sequence component. And what will be the zero sequence component? That is xs plus 2xm. This is the zero sequence impedance. So we can tell that positive sequence impedance and negative sequence impedance in a transmission line is same, but what about the zero sequence impedance? That is different. Now, next question is, now we have a question that why in parallel transmission line positive and negative mutual coupling is zero but not zero sequence. Okay, so if two transmission line is operating in parallel, then why positive and negative mutual coupling between those two line is zero but not zero sequence? Okay, there will be some zero sequence mutual coupling. See, suppose first of all, mutual coupling depend upon the distance between pair of two transmission line. Okay, so if distance is more, then there will be no mutual coupling between those two line. Okay, now let three phase line running in parallel. Okay, suppose this is line A and this is line B. Okay, these are the transposed network. Okay, so this is line A and this is line B. Okay, so suppose this is line 1, A1, this is B1, this is C1. And this is A2, this is B2, this is C2. Now, according to Ampere current law, what is the closed interval of HI DL? This is nothing but net current, okay, in that surface. Now, if line carries पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव सीक्वेंस करंट इफ लाइन कैरीज पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव सीक्वेंस करंट then there will be no mutual coupling, there will be no mutual coupling, okay, because what will be the I net value here? I net will be Ia plus Ib plus Ic, right? So if you take the positive sequence current, what it will be? Ia plus a square Ib, sorry, Ia, a square Ia plus a Ia, right? What is Ic? A Ia for positive sequence. Now, if I take common Ia, what will get? 1 plus a square plus a, and what is 1 plus a square? That is equal to 0, so this will give you 0. Same as negative sequence component, okay? So, if line carries positive and negative sequence component, then there will be no mutual coupling. There will be no mutual coupling. Okay? But if line carries zero sequence current, if line carry zero sequence current, the flux then the flux linkage with such, why this is lagging, A2 with circuit A2, then it will not be equal to 0, right? Not be equal to 0. Okay. Suppose in this network the mutual coupling between mutual impedance between A2 and first circuit is alpha. Suppose mutual coupling between line A2 with A1, B1 and C1 is alpha. Okay, then what will be delta VA1, delta VA2, sorry, VB1 and delta VC1. Here 1 is representing circuit 1, okay, don't take it as positive sequence. So 1 represent here circuit is equal to what we got, ZS, ZM, 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 ZS, ZM, ZM, sorry, every time writing X, this is ZM. This is ZM and this is ZS. Okay, this into current IA1, IB1 and this is IC1. Plus, here also we will write mutual impedance, that is J alpha. Here I use identical matrix. Okay, into IA2. IB2 and IC2. Okay. Now, if we convert this into symmetrical component, what will get delta V naught 1, delta V 1 1 and delta V 2 1. Okay. If we convert this into symmetrical component, what will get? This will be Zs plus 2 Zm. Because I wrote here negative sequence. Okay. Don't confuse with this. Here I wrote negative sequence component in the third row and here in the first row. So this will be Zs plus 2 Zm 0 0, this will be 0, this will be Zs minus Zm, this will be 0, this will be Zs minus Zm, right? And here you will get current component, that is I naught 1, I 1 1 and this will be I 2 1 plus here you will get J 3 alpha 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 into symmetrical component. So what will be symmetrical component? I naught 2, I 1 2, I 2 2. Okay. This 2 represent second circuit and this represent component, symmetrical component. This is negative sequence current, this is positive sequence current and this is negative sequence current. Sorry, this is zero sequence current, this is positive sequence current and this is negative sequence current. Okay. So as you can see, all the positive sequence component here is 0 and negative sequence component is 0. What we left off? We left with negative sequence current, negative sequence. Okay. So we can tell that mutual coupling with parallel lines zero sequence will not be equal to 0. Okay. Next, fault in which ground is involved it will not affected by mutual coupling. Okay, like line to line, three phase fault. Okay, so this fault will not be affected by mutual coupling. And fault in which ground is involved, it will get affected by mutual coupling. For example, single line to ground, okay, double line to ground. So these are the fault which is affected by mutual coupling. Fault involved ground, fault current will get affected by mutual coupling. For example, single line to ground, double line to ground. Okay, so these are the fault which is affected by mutual coupling. Okay.